won by McClellans. Gibbs, that's a great ball from Gibbs, and Barnes has caught the defence square. It's Barnes against Judge, it's 1-0. That's a superb goal, but give credit to Gibbs for the initial ball. And John Barnes opens the scoring for Watford. With 6 minutes gone. Beautifully put through. Sterling for Blissett. Sterling again, the players outside him if he wants him. That's Barnes's cross, and it's come now for Bardsley, and Bardsley carries it superbly, and that will have made the youngsters' day. That will settle everybody down. Goal early in the first half, then not really fulfilling the potential for the rest of that 45-minute spell. At the start of the second period, Watford get the second goal. Now Sterling off on his travels again. It's a great ball for Blissett, and that's 3-0, and that's a superb strike. But give Royal Sterling credit for a super smooth ball. And let the crowd tell you who got it. The smile on the face. Blank score sheet. Watford's probably very disappointed with their inability so far to penetrate this Wimbledon defence. Pretty alarming in some respects. Hodges. Oh, and Richardson in trouble, and Hodges. Can he? He can! And suddenly, a disaster in the defence. Hodges and Wise, and only Richardson in the defence for Watford. And they've made him pay for it. Steve Terry, Rostrum chasing. Was a forlorn chase. Ewan Roberts came down from the Welsh Hills last year as an apprentice. Once again, Tom Wally, the Watford youth team manager, finding some pretty promising talent. And the question now is whether Roberts and one or two others have the potential realised. Roberts has won this one well. Now Callaghan. Will he have a go himself? He'll find Roberts, who can shoot. And Ewan Roberts sends the Vicarage Road crowd This time it's a goal kick. And the cheers as Nigel Callaghan, Watford substitute, is set to warm up. Cries of We Love You Wednesday. There's a racehorse that runs in that name that's had a bit of success this season. Now Chamberlain, he's done well. Driven in and Terry, oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. The centre halves, nightmare. And Mark Chamberlain sent the sort of cross in that Watford couldn't do anything with. Second match in a fortnight's time up at Spotland, and I should think Rochdale, if they can do well here, might well fancy their chances of certainly financial bonanza, if nothing more. And David Grant with their first throw. Alan Young and Neil Mills are the Rochdale substitutes, and one of the fascinating things about this game is that for the first time since Watford's European season, we see the sight of more than one substitute able to come on in a match. Clearance away was by Jason Smart. And in goal, Rochdale have David Redfern. Just got one victory to their credit this season, have Rochdale, and that was against Colchester on Saturday. Scored a few goals, but conceded plenty as well. Wackenshaw. And he's fed Peter Conning. Conning. Oh, my word! And what a start for the fourth division side. Peter Conning has stunned the Watford faithful. A couple of them inquiring of John Mulls. And, John Brummel has got a knock. He is in the centre of the picture, Peter Conning, Bachelor of Science and formerly with Altrincham. His goal, well, we shall see how significant that might yet become. Here's the corner from Callaghan. Barnes knocks it on, Rostron, and the equalising goal. His first of the season. It across to challenge. Good cross as well. The corner conceded by Bardsley. With very few real alternatives. East End folk try to lift their side. Here's Paris with the corner. Terry away, Dickens, and in! Well, Coton got a hand to it. Terry knocked it down, and the left foot of Alan Dickens got enough power. Not struggling for the third time. Richardson trying to come in, and away come West Ham on the quick breakaway. Ward has given it away to Richardson. Here's Callaghan. Barnes inside, Roberts in the middle, and Callaghan in turn has lost it. McClelland, not giving Mr. Cotty much distance. Cotty, McAvenny's arriving in the middle, and McAvenny has made it 2-0. Very, very easy indeed. Out jumps Steve Terry. And it's 2-0 West Ham. Parks perhaps has been the busier of the two keepers in this first half hour. West Ham, two goals to the good. Sinnott, now Blissett. Callahan is free to the right, and Callahan himself. Blissett has gone into the middle. Oh, he's put it in! He's put it in as Callahan. I was looking to see where the middle ball was coming from. Blissett was there, Barnes was arriving, and he fooled us all. A low dipper. Suddenly there is a chink of light. And he's lost out to Paris. Giveni and Cotty trying to come through. In the end, Sinnott. We've not been under any real threat in this half so far. Couple of chances that Watford have had. Still a tight and gripping contest. Well, the chase is on between Gale and Parks and Blissett, and that is 2-2. Disaster for West Ham. Gale is hurt as well. As he and Parks clashed for the same ball. Walters wanting a word with Jacket. Jacket just ignores him. That's yet again one's thoughts about all ticket games. 16,000 here today and it's not all ticket, and against West Ham where the opposition had considerably less far to come, rather less than 1,000 more. 17,100 for Watford's last home game, and that was a fortnight ago. That's the free kick. Jacket away. Callahan. Oh, he tried to dribble it out the way and he's lost it. Now Walters. That's a dipping one and it's there. Well, he struck it well. And Nigel Callahan will be very, very displeased with himself. Trying to dribble the ball out of defence. So what sort of response? That setback can Watford produce. McClelland looking for Falco. Norton away. Hartley did well in the air. Falco won it well. Callahan. Bissett's arriving in the middle. Falco's there too. Spink hasn't caught it. Falco! 1-1! And on his home debut. Squares it all up. Elton John on his feet. And he'll be well pleased with that. And how will Villa react to having had the lead for such a short period of time? Birch. Dorigo's cross. Coton's catch. He certainly increased the noise level around Vicarage Road, that's for sure. And he's got somewhere to go to match the explosions of fireworks before the start. McClelland, Barnes, twisting and turning. Can he get his cross in? He can. Spink hasn't got it. Falco! So... and the Smiles tell their own triumphant story. Barnes stand the left. Villa didn't get it. Falco 2 in 2 minutes. And Vicarage Road goes wild. Barnes. And Lovington Emerson Griffith says it's a Watford throw. He's one of the most amiable characters about. I'm sitting with him at lunchtime watching England and West Germany and on a World Hockey semi-final. His enthusiasm knows no bounds. Here's Blissett trying to cross it. Barnes, Bardsley, that's a useful looking cross. Falco's got up, Jacket, and did it go in off the defender? Well, Kenny Jacket will claim it. Again, it was the menace in the air. And they don't move on the bench, they show no emotion at all. And he's onside, Hodge. Now he's got a real chance. Coton came and smothered superbly. Great goalkeeping by the Watford keeper. Narrowed his angle. And smothered Hodge's goal attempt. And that might have made a difference to have clawed it back to 3-2. Just as I said, Watford mustn't allow themselves to be caught out at the back. Well, things are as they are up front. Here's Blissett, he's done well, he's got to the byline. Spink hasn't got it, Falco, the hat-trick! Well, that one will surely be the easiest of the lot, and here they are, there's the chairman on his feet as well. All the club directors, Elton John on his feet. Oh, they love that. Okay, this time doing the defending. And Coton, I'll make a point to the linesman. The ball certainly crossed the line and went back in again. I must say, after one's experiences with officialdom in the Watford camp a week ago, the teamwork between Mr. Crossley and Mr. Griffith on the line, Mike James in the middle, it's been very pleasing. And it's gone in by Simon Stainrod. Bad mistake in the Watford defence. And Aston Villa have a second.
Rostron with it towards John Barnes. Again he wins it well in the air. Allen now playing it for Barnes again. The cross is in there. Fox, good save. The cross coming in there by John Barnes, the 36-year-old Phil Parks equal to it. Goddard. And here's Devonshire. Goddard.
Let's get him go! Phil Goddard! Well, you've got a good view of that. An absolutely stupendous goal. And the West Ham travelling fans celebrate with about 12 minutes gone. again Devonshire, who has prompted everything that's looked profitable for West Ham so far tonight, plays it here for Goddard. Rifling past Sherwood. So there's plenty of activity there in that West Ham area, as you can see. And it was Gale who got up, and a penalty given for Gale pushing down on the Watford attacker. The referee, Sir Geoff Gray, says a penalty. Now what we'll see is Kenny Jackett taking it. And it looked to me like Tony Gale, who was leaning in on his man. Now Kenny Jackett scored from the penalty spot at Goodison on Saturday, a very distinctive penalty style in point of fact. He takes only a couple of yards and plays it normally to the goalkeeper's left. Well, he's taking a few more yards this time, and to the goalkeeper's left, and Watford are level. Well, there's a relief for Watford and their fans as Kenny Jackett makes it 1-1. Well, you don't save those. Now Stewart, trying to get Ward away. He's got a bit of pace about him, and he's got in behind Rostron this time, fading there towards Goddard. And a corner given. Defenders are forward again. Bale and Hilton. And his little Mark Ward takes this corner for West Ham. Bale's header. Punched by Sherwood. Devonshire trying to come in. Gale again. Or playing it wide. A bit of space here for Ward. Good thoughtful play here by West Ham. And time for Devonshire now to measure up something. And it's in there by Dickens. It just about crept over the line, but it's put West Ham back into the lead. Well, they're jumping for joy again after Kenny Jackett's penalty had made it 1-1. And Devonshire again is the man who set it up. And it was only half hit there by Alan Dickens, and he had to wait to see if it even crossed the line. Hilton. For Watford, or planting it back again. This time it's Terry. Hilton's got to do some jumping now. Harris gets in too. Dickens to Devonshire. Good play by Devonshire. Splendid play. And what a lovely ball. As Devonshire now gets Potty away. McClellan's after him. Still with Potty. He's picked up Ward. Given there by Ward. Magnificent goal. Watford were back at their throats. Splendid play again by Devonshire. Look at that, a magnificent ball. He's played some brilliant balls in the midfield. Potty holding off McClellan superbly, and then spots the number 7 coming in. And Ward is a great striker of a ball. And here he comes to prove that point and put West Ham 3-1 ahead. Rostron. Again, Gale gets it away. Gone anywhere, and a touch, although the flag was up. He said to continue play. Sterling being pursued by Gale. He's got Allen waiting in the middle. Beautiful goal there, scored by the fullback David Bardsley, that brings Watford right back into this game. It's a lovely run down the left here by young Worrall Sterling. A deep cross that eluded Allen, but look at Bardsley coming in to thunder it past Phil Parks and make it 3-2. We'll be right back.
first team plays of right. Shipley's header was meant for Stewart. Shipley in again. Stewart will chase. Sims trying to close him down. Hazelwood. It hasn't gone. And he peaked there first. Watford thought it had gone and they were quite happy to watch. And Shipley's made them pay for it. Austin and Jacket and one or two others looking at each other. George Shipley. Bardsley's throw. Falco. Three minutes of injury time played. We have Watford time to launch one more assault. One wonders. Here's Barnes. That's nice. Blissett. Falco is coming and makes it 1-1. And it ran for him in the penalty area. But Mark Falco gets the fifth goal of his Watford career. McClelland. Here's John Barnes. Charlton's throw. Is onside. Falco is arriving fast in the middle. He's picking his spot and scores. Oh, super! And he picked his spot, and it's his 100th senior goal, and surely as good as any of them. Blissett, the supplier, and Falco, the executioner. But he had to. Which was to clear the danger. It's McClellan's clearance. Peak. Shipley. Shipley again. Hazelwood. Now Richardson. Callahan. Now he's off on his travels with Bardsley outside him. Bardsley's cut inside. Callahan fed it through for the fullback. Bardsley. Oh, super strike. Oh, what a goal. Made by Callahan and brilliantly taken by Bardsley. His third goal of the season. And now there is daylight for Watford. It's 3-1. Shipley. And suddenly the tunnel for Charlton is much darker. Stewart. Oh, and it went right across the face of the goal. Jacket. Callahan again. Blissett steaming forward. In the middle in space. Callahan's cross. That's nice. Could Blissett find it? Yes, he can. It's four. Charlton ripped apart by two in a minute. Both made by Callahan and finishing this time devastating from Blissett. Matthews has waited for it. He didn't come. Richardson won it again. Venus. David Bardsley. That's beautifully done for Callahan. And Venus concedes the corner. Really looking to go out our Watford and take the game by the scruff of the neck. Make life difficult for the visitors. Sims nodded it on. Rostron, 1-0. Almost an exact replica of the goals that went in at Filbert Street last season. Sims playing the crucial part, looking on the corner to really deceive the goalkeeper. Dearly love, as I said earlier, to add the second goal to the one he got against Norwich way back in September. Jacket. Richardson, Falco. Here's Jacket again. Blissett is going forward. Barnes is going wide. Here's Barnes. Rostron. Falco. Clearance for Barnes. Oh, a smashing strike! Oh, that's the mark of John Barnes. Came to him first time in the corner. 2-0. Number two for Leicester City was Morgan. McAllister. Bunce. To try and get players forward where they can, Leicester. McAllister was in there. Rostron was in there first. Bardsley. Callahan. Need to find Barnes. O'Neill away. Not decisively, bless it for Callahan. And Andrews left his near post exposed. And the poor goalkeeper holds his head in his hands. And Callahan has made him pay for an appalling blunder. Whether he miskicked it, I don't think he really minds. Andrews expecting the cross to the far post. And it went in at his near post. And it's 3-0. Jacket away. Kevin Richardson. Played forward for Callahan. Falco's in the space in the middle. Good cross. Just didn't quite have the direction that he wanted. Disastrous goal kick from Andrews. O'Neill and Falco. And Falco makes it four. A complete disaster by Ian Andrews from the goal kick. Played it straight to Falco. He shook off O'Neill. Barnes. Porter. McClelland. Richardson. Barnes staying forward, so too is. Oh, that's Barnes. Twisting and turning. Oh, down he goes with the referee a yard away. And there can be no question about that, whatever. John Shaw could not have been closer. and Kenny Jackett, who has become something of a penalty specialist with three in the last five games against Everton, West Ham and Newcastle, makes it four in six games, and Watford go nap. Well struck spot kick. And it is five. Ryan Hamilton, the team manager of Leicester, is not a happy man. Sitting on the bench there. McClelland, oh dear. McClelland again. Smith, and they've got one back. Shut off McClelland's challenge. Coton came, and the defence caught napping, and Coton will be very disappointed, because it's a matter of professional pride for a goalkeeper to keep a clean sheet. Free kick, and they're all up ready to run at Watford here. Callahan got the back flick, Jackett, and the corner is deflected. With Kenny Jackett's shot, and the ball with vast quantities of mud all over it. And across to take it again. McClelland is right up. Barnes on near post. Terry beyond him. Barnes got it. McClelland! And Watford are in front! And the old set-piece routine yet again. Callahan. Barnes knock on. And in a similar way to the diminutive Will Frostron steaming in, they had one home against Leicester in the last home game. Rush losing out, Barnes is away again. Now Barnes. Falco's arriving in the middle, Grobbelaar's not got the cross. Falco, that's a marvellous save by Grobbelaar. Falco thought he'd got the second, and it was an inch-perfect cross from Barnes that gave him the chance. But Grobbelaar's save was quite magnificent. And the foul by Marlon Whelan, giving Liverpool another chance to get down the other end and relieve their own defenders, who are certainly working overtime at the moment. Liverpool sub Barry Venison is starting to warm up. It's not so much a question, I think, of them doing that. That's Barnes, and he's on his way. Got beautifully past Gillespie. Hansen is coming across, so is Beglin. Here's Barnes, and he's made it! Oh, what a marvellous strike! A moment of international genius. And they do not come better than that. Beat Gillespie. The players came in and one thought, well, Barnes has got problems here because he's got players coming in, and he buried it as clear as you like. Jackson. Made his debut yesterday. Newcastle with all sorts of problems, with no Anderson and no McCreary available still. Their injury list is more than a trifle alarming. Penny Wharton. Darren Jackson. And again, he's given it away to Jacket. Barnes, that's nice. Jacket again. There's forward here in directions if he wants them. Henry Porter square. It's a long one forward. Franco will jump. He'll knock it in for Barnes, and that's 1-0. It all stemmed from the good jump by Gary Porter's cross for Mark Falco. Falco getting up well, and Barnes gets his third goal in three home games. As though ball control and football in general is going to be at its most difficult. Callahan suckling well before Mark Falco could get there. Jacket, and Porter's got away. Barnes is arriving. Molto rapido is Barnes, and it's 1-0. Beautiful control from Barnes, and Falco the supplier. And Barnes, who got what turned out to be the winner on Saturday for Watford against Newcastle, makes it 5. His goal still settles it. Something will certainly clear long, and does. Grealish. Rostron. Throw-in seen given Manchester City's way. Wilf Rostron wasn't happy. And I must say, I thought it was a Watford throw. And given to City, Gidman, McNabb. McCarthy. Sims. McNabb, Coton, and he hasn't got it. Monferrati's made it pay for it. And City steam in at the death to make it 1-1. How nice it is to see the non-league side prepared to have a go. Question of them trying to make money by putting the shutters up and trying to play for a draw to take it back to London Road on Wednesday night. Gary Porter seeds the throw. And Sims, Galloway, yes! Now McClelland. Callahan played it for Bardsley. Barnes. And the free kick is Watford's. Now, Barnes with the free kick. Players ready to run in all directions. And we get a corner. Once again, no risks being taken by Maidstone. Being roused for these final few moments of the half. Just to keep their heads. Barnes knocks on. Falco! And in! And the First Division side get the goal from the set piece. Knock on at the near post. And Falco no more than 3 yards out. Maidstone, though, haven't seemed under any kind of pressure at all. Allen for Rostron. Jacket knocks in. Allen trying to get in again. McClelland. Bardsley. Callahan. Bardsley again. Nigel Callahan. Who will try and put in the cross? Allen! Beautifully done! And the youngster strikes inside 2 minutes from the Callahan cross. Richardson then with the free kick. And Derek Richardson. Is fouled by Callahan. Jacket. And is there still time for Maidstone to launch one last onslaught? Look at the watch from Roger Milford. And Watford, for all this, just have a slight doubt in the back of one's mind. As long as it's only 2-1. Barnes. That's a beautiful ball for Allen. Now, can he put over the cross? Falco, and now there is no doubt. And that was a goal of First Division quality. And it takes him into double figures. Good boy, he says to Malcolm Allen. And he's played a very important part in the outcome of the game.
Watford into the lead with 16 minutes gone. Hutchison.
And Barber gathering an important ball, claimed that he was hounded unfairly by Falco. And there was certainly a feeling in the Walsall camp that Falco had fouled the keeper. Walsall scored their important goal on Saturday. Word there from the referee. Coming in towards Malcolm Allen. Walker's there. He's given a penalty. He's given a penalty by Walker on Allen. Well, let's look again. There was a penalty in the first game, of course. That went to Walsall. Well, I couldn't see anything there. But from this angle, I certainly couldn't see it. I think of Shakespeare, and Kenny Jackett will take the penalty. Seven goals this season, four of them in the penalty spot, and very often is, you know, sometimes he just takes a couple of steps only, but a few more this time. But Barber has been quite a barrier to beat so far tonight, but he's beaten this time, and Watford, to immense relief all around Vicarage Road, are back in it. Some thought it was a controversial penalty on Saturday that Walsall had, and many will feel the same about the one tonight. Free kick to Walsall.
Still okay. Pereyra Hart battling valiantly at the back. But Falco's got possession for Watford. Nice turn by him and a cross in a deflection. Might be Barnes in! 3-2! With a quarter of an hour to go, the applause rings out at last for Watford. Twice behind, twice level. Richardson having played it across there. Good work here by Falco. The deflection that took it neatly into the path of John Barnes. Well, they're not over and done with yet, and they've got a corner, Walsall. Paul Jones will take it, a real utility player. He's played in just about every position except goal. Now taking this corner, he's done a good job in the midfield as well, but McClellan gets that one away. Played by Shakespeare for Jones again, played in there. And they've done it! Well, that's amazing!
Rostron looking for Bardsley, but it was an invitation to full power, which he accepted. Heath, cross to Vandenhout. Everton beginning to move with purpose now. Heath is outside, but power is outside him too. And Heath comes in, and a goal for Everton by Adrian Heath. And he'll be thrilled about that because he's been going through a really thin spell. But Everton have taken the lead, and Vandenhout
to Power, whose earlier interception really set this move up. It was the driven cross, and Heath came in to head it in at the near post. Only his second goal in the last 13 games, but it does confirm his position as Everton's top scorer. It's his 16th of the season.
Watford on the attack. Falco's there. Watson was with him. Away by Reid. Back by Sims. Now Barnes. Rostron. Falco. Oh, he tried to head that down to Blissett. Bardsley's there. Watson is also. This is Gibbs.
Blissett! Oh, yes! Luther Blissett! 1-1! Wow, that's a spectacular goal. And Luther, one of the most popular players ever to wear a Watford shirt, gets a fantastic reception for that. Nigel Gibbs volleyed it across, and Blissett stooped to head that past Southall, who could only stand and admire it. It happened so fast that the goalkeeper was left standing. Driven by Gibbs, and a flying header by Blissett makes it 1-1. And the lad who came on as substitute at half-time in the right-back position makes the goal.
Forgettable match in the first half has become an absorbing one in the second, and with 5 minutes left we could still see a dramatic finale. This is Bardsley for Watford.
Falco, no! Barnes, no! Falco, yes! We have got the dramatic finale. Mark Falco, 2-1 to Watford. And what might that goal do to the championship race?
To throw for Arsenal. Going to win this side is Terence Healy. Next Sunday afternoon, he lines the full members' cup final at Wembley between Blackburn Rovers and Charlton Athletic. And if you want something even more ironic, the man who will referee that game, Mr. Brian Stevens, the man who was involved in the match between these two sides last Saturday afternoon. Blissett, Rostron, Porter on the overlap in a bit of space, and Porter doing well. But it was a glorious chip by Will Frostron that started it. And he will return the compliment, I'm sure, by going to shake the hand of his little friend from Wearside.
Falco.
Moved on by Sims. Here's Kevin Richardson. Nigel Gibbs. Rick's covering back. Bardsley. Still Bardsley. And almost for Falco. And Gus Caesar relieved. Played out for the corner, but it was well run by Bardsley, who got into the position to put over the cross.
Under 15 minutes to go. Sims and Blissett. It's two from the corner. A goal that puts Rupert Blissett in the Watford history books. Sims at the near post. Blissett simple header. It's 161 Watford goals for Luther Blissett, equaling Tommy Barnett's all-time record. McClelland by Bardsley. Here's West. Pat Nevin is going outside him, and Nevin racing against Rostron. And the first touch of the evening for Steve Sherwood, former Chelsea goalkeeper, of course. Here's Richardson. Falco, Gibbs. It's not a bad cross, Bardsley. Beautifully done. And the goalkeeper will not be pleased about letting one in at his near post. And that is just the start Watford needed. Gibbs from the right. And David Bardsley, totally unmarked, steaming in. Richardson's away. Chelsea can come back though, and have done. Here's Nevin. Surely try and go square with this if he can. onto the byline once more. Beautifully positioned, though, the referee to see it. Nevin will get nothing. Well, Taylor couldn't have been closer if he tried. The Chelsea fans were screaming for a penalty. So, Mr. Taylor, not in the slightest bit interested. Jones, off Steve Terry. It went off the defender. Will Frostrum then with the throw. Barnes. Terry, Gibbs, Falco, Porter, Rostron, looking to have a go, Gary Porter, oh what a strike, 25 yards, a bullet, an absolute bullet. Tremendous goal. Rostron laid it square. And Gary Porter just blasted it. Blissett. Oh, lovely strike. That is a gem. He's had his hair cut done for the occasion. McLaughlin not knowing where it was coming. And Blissett doing superbly. It's an ideal time now. Get the game by the scruff of the neck early in the second half and turn the possession advantage Watford will feel into goals. Another mistake by Luton has let in McClelland. Now Sterling. He'll have a go. Oh, what a strike! That's beautifully done. Blissett. Rostron drilled it in well. John Barnes, great cross, Luton get it away, but the defence at the moment is somewhat haphazard. Porter was prepared to have a go. Here's Sterling. Richardson might be in a better position. Barnes Sherwood coming to release the corner. Here's Downs. And deflected and in. But Downs will claim it.
Downs will take. Again, the big men being pushed up. Kilcline and Trevor Peake on their way forward here. Houchan, two! And the goalkeeper will have to ask about his position for that one. Barnes. Blissett. Now Barnes, there might be something on here because they've got a bit of space to work in at last. And they might be able to do something. Sterling, Falco and Blissett are in the middle. That's aim for Falco. And that is one back for Watford. Imperfect cross supplied by Sterling. Gibbs, Sterling, got well down there, Falco, Falco the executioner. Got 16 goals, 15 goals for Luther Blissett. 14 goals for John Barnes. Kilcline. McGrath. Played in by Regis. To know he's looking for it but wasn't going to give it. Barnes, and he's pushed down by Ardiles, and Mr. Lewis points straight to the penalty spot. And John Barnes, in what is almost certainly his final competitive game for the club, wins Watford a penalty, but a foul by Ozzy Ardiles. Lewis in no doubt about the decision at all. Richard Gough, I don't know what he's doing. And, I don't know why, whether Ray Lewis even ought to book him for protesting like that. That's a good penalty. And Watford are in the lead.
Click here for more videos.